All right, so good. Okay, hello everyone. This is Lawrence Lee. I'm the Vice President, Human Resources for Greater China and Mongolia from Hilton Worldwide. Very happy to join a call today and make this a very simple presentation on our strategy to engage, develop, and retain talent. We believe that the first step to winning in the talent best that we have is to build school alliances. Over the year, we have developed school alliances with Shenzhen Polytechnic in the south of China, Tianjin University of Commerce in the north, and with La Roche Xinjiang in the central. We also have school alliance in Malaysia with Taylor University, who had many students coming from China who are studying there and who are keen to come back to China to join the industry when they graduate. So this is what we have done in terms of building school alliances. We believe in engaging the talent right from the beginning. We organize what we call a Hilton class. They do their internship in our hotel, and at the end of the internship, they will join our hotels and be part of our talent pool. The other way that we engage our talent is to organize activities for the Gen Y. For example, on 28th and 29th of May this year, we had the Gen Y conference held in Shanghai, in China. It was a fantastic conference all together. There were 10 schools that participated. Besides our school alliances, we also had La Roche from Spain, from Switzerland, who joined us. We had Lyon and Blue Mountains from Australia, and Kendall College from Chicago. So it was truly a global conference. It impacted all around the world. Just to give you some numbers of the participants, all in all, we had 320 delegates. 224 of them were students from 36 nationalities and 15 countries. Why do we do this conference? Because it positions Hilton Worldwide as employer of choice in Asia and especially in China. Build school alliances, strengthen our school alliances established in Asia. In terms of recruitment and talent spotting, it promotes the management training program that we have in Greater China and Mongolia. And it also gives people worldwide, our group facilitators who are present at the conference to spot talent and enable recruitment. During the conference, we conducted a Gen Y survey so that we can understand what they want in their careers. We also asked the participants to do projects which were prepared in advance of the conference. And during the conference, they presented projects on what they look for as a business and leisure traveler. So we learned a lot through the engagement with the Gen Y during the conference. Last but not least, we built brand recognition and goodwill. It was generated through the media coverage. We did a press conference and press release, and from the media report, we know that we generated more than 1 million RMB worth of advertising revenue through the conference. That is, we would have to spend 1 million RMB on advertising if we had not organized the conference. But by the media coverage that we had, we were able to get a lot of free publicity. And this was good for us in terms of building brand recognition and goodwill. A very pleasant surprise for us is that during the survey that was done in conjunction with the conference, we were voted by the students and the world, not just in Shanghai, but all around the world. All those schools that we saw earlier on participating, the students voted us as the top or the favorite hotel chain to look for in Asia. So that was a great result for us. And this shows again that the way to win the hearts of the young talent is to engage them. The more they get to know you, the more they understand what Hilton Worldwide is all about, you can find that they start to be receptive to the idea of joining us to begin their career after graduation. This is just some pictures of what the January conference was all about. It was a conference that was full of energy and full of discovery as we engage and work with the young generation. You may also wonder why do we engage the Gen Y in China. All in all, there are 200 million Gen Y in China alone. That is like almost a two-thirds the population of the U.S., 10 times the population of Australia, and 40 times the population of Singapore. So it is a huge labor market, a talent pool for us to tap on. So that's why we emphasize our genuine engagement so much in China. Now, as a result of the January conference, we had a very good response for our management training program that we launched in China. Just to give you some idea of what the management training program is all about, we were very focused on what we were looking for. We wanted China Nationally Mobile and Chinese National to join us in this program because we believe very much in building a sustainable talent model that is based on developing Chinese national, developing our local talent. That's why we focus on this category of talent. We look for people who have at least a three-year diploma education or equivalent. And because of the nature of our industry, we look for people who are fluent in English and able to achieve a certain level of English proficiency in China. So this was the selection criteria that we used for our national training program. Because of the publicity and the way we have engaged the talent through Gen Y conference and other initiatives, in fact, we have a very active internet strategy, which I do not have the time to elaborate today, but engaging our talent through internet, through Weibo, through other means like Youku, which is China equivalent of YouTube. Weibo is the Chinese equivalent of Facebook and Twitter, and through engaging the Blackboard forums in the schools. Through many strategies that we use for the internet, we're able to generate a lot of interest and response to our national training program. For example, we received 7,000 over applications for the national training program, and from that we eventually selected 116. So it's almost 1 out of 100 was successful. Eventually, 80 of them joined our hotel. So it was a very successful program for us, the results. And I would say that a lot of the results was because of the way we engaged the talent through the internet and also through activities like the Gen Y conference, through school discussions, and through presentations that we made in schools. All these help us to get such great results. I thought it was interesting to share with you how we select our young talent through the management training program. Instead of just relying on looking at the resume or doing simple interviews, what we did was we invited those that were shortlisted to come to what we call assessment center. We set up three assessment centers, one in Guangzhou, one in Beijing, and one in Shanghai. And they came to the assessment center. We made them go through group activities. And then if you look at the picture on the far right corner, we actually assessed them. We have one assessor to one participant or one candidate, and we actually do a very thorough assessment of their behavior and during the activity so that we know them much better. Another thing that we did was we made them do an impromptu speech. So every person who came to the assessment center had to make a speech, and the speech was given to them. The topic was given to them only 2 minutes before they had to make the speech. They had 2 minutes to deliver a speech on the topic. This is again a way to assess and find out how they are like. Are they able to think on their feet? Are they able to speak clearly and able to communicate well in the English language? So that was what we did for the speech. And of course, the last stage of the assessment center was the interview. So when the interviewer met the candidate, they already had the results of the group activity as well as the speech activity. So they were able to make a much better judgment of the candidate. And as I was saying earlier on, once we had gone through all the interviews, we shortlisted 115 who were selected. And now the 115, eventually 80 of them joined our hotels. So it was a very successful event for us. Great teamwork. We had 60 hotels, or rather 50 team members from our hotels involved in every assessment center. So 150 of our team members were actually involved in the assessment and interviewing of the candidates. That included the general managers, the ex-com members, as well as many managers of different levels. Yeah, the other thing that I was mentioning earlier on is that we are very much engaged in the social media with the talent out there in China. And through Weibo, through Youku, through Sapier and many other websites, to 51job.com, to ChinaHR.com, to VeryEase.com. These are all for our China websites and internet social media sites. We found that this was very effective in engaging the young talent that we have in China. As you know, China is pretty active in the internet. There are many micro-blogging, there's many interaction that goes on in the internet. And we felt that this is one of the best ways for us to reach out to the talent. And through this focused approach, we can see that there are many good results that have come out from social media engagement. We know for now that Hilton Worldwide is the top international hotel name in China on the internet. This is done using what we call the NBI index, which tracks and see how much publicity and how much activity on the internet is related to the Hilton name. So we're very happy to see that we have very high interest in our name on the internet, especially in China. Five of our Hilton Worldwide hotels were voted in the top 300 best employer award on VeryEase.cn. Again, this is through the internet and through voting. 200,000 people were involved in the voting, and it was great to see that five of our hotels are among the top 300 best employers in China. Another area that we did very well was when ChinaHR.com did a survey of 50,000 of their users. Hilton Worldwide was voted last year and this year as the best employer in China. This was done using a survey, And it was great to see that the name is growing and that recognition of Hilton worldwide as an employer of choice is growing very much in China. The news itself of us winning the best employer in China was another boost for people to get to know Hilton worldwide. We put out a press release announcing our win of the Best Employer Award, and we tracked the response, and we found out that 81 million readers actually viewed the news that we were the best employer. So it was great for us. The 81 million people showed interest in the news. The other thing that we do a lot in terms of engaging the talent is corporate responsibility. Throughout all the surveys that we've done of Gen Y and the studies that have been made, it is a very clear indication that the young generation wants to work for companies that care for the environment, that care for the community. So this is one of our key strategies in terms of engaging the talent and attracting them to join us. The other thing we also notice is that they look for companies that provide them with opportunities to develop themselves. I think that's where the Global Future Worldwide University is definitely an advantage to us in terms of attracting and developing talent. The Global Hilton Worldwide University in 1 year has delivered 5 million hours of training. We have 60,000 registered users at the Hilton Worldwide University. All in all, we provide 2,000 training courses for our people to take, our team members to take online. And on top of that, we have another 300 leadership courses available. So Hilton Worldwide University is definitely an advantage for us, a competitive advantage for us in terms of attracting and developing our talent. We also have many other learning and development programs besides those online, which we use regionally and we use globally to develop our talent. Here's a chart that shows what kind of clear career development we offer to our talent, and at different levels, we offer different courses and development programs for them. And this is a huge attraction for us when we talk to our talent. This is something many of them look for, a clear career path, as well as a clear development of their competencies and of their professional expertise as they continue to work with us. You can see here that as a person join us as a team member, we have various graduate schemes and development programs for them. And as they move up the ladder from a team leader to a department head, we have various leadership workshops, we have various leadership programs, our program we call the Leadership One, and MAP, which is the Management Awareness Program. So we have various programs that we run for our team members as they grow into a department head. And when they want to become a part of the hotel executive team, we have an in-house program called Shine 4D and Shine GM. And when they become a general manager, we also have many programs for them. For example, e-commerce, and also Harvard Management Talk. There are many programs that we use for them to develop themselves. The other thing that we realized that was very important for the talent market is a strong corporate culture. So besides corporate responsibility, we also realized that they were very much interested in the culture, the corporate culture of the company that is joining. So we emphasize a lot on things like recognition programs. Hilton Worldwide have our own website just dedicated to recognition of our team members. We have many programs recognition of our team members, and in fact, we have even have a recognition calendar, which basically states for every month which department we want to recognize, what aspect of the business we want to put emphasis on. So there's a whole year round of employee recognition program that we run in Hilton Worldwide. And of course, we also have many very strong brand activities and training that we do. For example, the Blue Energy for the Hilton brand, and so on. So at various brands, we have different training programs to motivate and to keep our culture strong in our company. So these are some of the things we do with this. We also organize activities for all our hotels in terms of recognizing our team members. This is one program that we did recently in line with the Olympics in London. As you know, Hilton Worldwide is the sponsor of the China Olympic team in China, and we did a contest here called Staff in London for all hotels in China, and at the end we selected 8 of them from our various hotels to go to London to be part of the Hilton Worldwide team that was in the Olympics promoting and engaging people during the Olympics. These are all the finalists that came from our various hotels, and the general manager came to support them as well. And it was a fantastic contest. Literally thousands and thousands of our team members in China were involved in the competition. Because they all went through, many of them participated. In the end, we selected 27 finalists, and from the 27 finalists, we selected 8 winners to go to London to represent Hilton Worldwide to the Olympics. So it was a great experience for us, and it was a fantastic time of recognition for the talent that we have in our hotels. In China alone, we have 12,000 team members working for us. And this was a great way to engage them, to recognize them. Yes, so that in a nutshell is what we do in China in terms of engaging, developing and retaining our talent. Happy to say that we have achieved pretty good results so far, winning the Best Employer Award twice in a row in China. We have been able to attract talent to join our hotels, those who open. Usually, our hotels, when we do a mass recruitment, we will have, we are able to attract enough talent to come and join us. We also do other strategies to develop our talent. We develop what we call talent pipeline. We look at certain positions which we find we do have a challenge in recruiting, and then we plan a talent pipeline based on internal talent that we identify through our talent review, and then we use a very focused development program to get them ready to become head of department and also to become executive committee members, and eventually from there we hope to identify general managers that would be part of our program. So far, we are pretty successful in developing general managers. 75% of our GMs in China have either been promoted or internally transferred. So happy to say that we have a big pool of GM talent that we can tap on whenever we have a new hotel opening in China. Yep, so that's what I would like to share with everybody. So happy to take any questions that anyone may have. Thank you.
Thank you, Lawrence. That was great. You always do a terrific job, and I really appreciate you you know, speaking to our students here about what you're doing there. One question I would ask you, because I know, as I will tell them, you have a variety of backgrounds in human resources in Asia, Europe, and even, I believe, North America. What do you find that's different about what you were just talking about that you're doing, particularly related to, like, management training aspects in mainland China, in your region?
Well, I think, first of all, the talent pool is tremendous in China. As I mentioned earlier on, we have 200 million Gen Y available for us to tap on in China. So we project that we will need 20,000 team members in the coming year. But if you look at 20,000 that we need compared with the 200 million that's available, you can see that the potential to fill up these positions with very talented people is very great. So I would say that in China, they are blessed with abundant human resources. The question is engaging them correctly, attracting them correctly, and then developing and retaining them once they join us. So the challenge, I would say, is quite different from if I compare with Singapore or other places around the world where the talent is not that abundant and where there's a lot of import of foreign talent, for example, in places like the Middle East. And that is you need a totally different strategy and approach when you're faced with such a different talent market. The other thing I would say about the Chinese talent that join us, either as team members or as management trainees or team leaders, I'm always very impressed by the talent that join us. In general, I find that Chinese talent are very hardworking. They're willing to learn, very hungry for success, and they are able to be very focused on developing themselves and on building a career that will last in the industry that they choose. So these are things that look very well for us. The other thing is there's a very strong sense of family and loyalty, and this is very good for people worldwide because we are in the people business, and we are looking for people who care for people who are interested in others. People who have a strong loyalty to other individuals. So these are things that work very well for us. It is very different in other places I work. For example, in Europe, the approach is different compared with China. Yeah, I think that are some of the key differences. How people were right to responding to this different.
Yes, yes, absolutely, absolutely. You know, let me ask you a question on a different perspective. You've worked for a domestic brand, if you will, and the largest one in Zhenjiang, and you've worked for the international Hilton brand, and one of the things about the aspect of both training and retaining has to do with this development in Asia, particularly in China, of these academies where you develop something as you've done before. What is your thought about that in terms of effectiveness of how you go about doing that, creating your own internal academy, using outside resources like you were talking about you're using now with Hilton? What are your feelings about that?
I think it's very important for any hotel company to invest in the development of their talent. And I think one of the key strategies is to have something that they can use in-house that is fully focused on their internal talent that meets their specific needs. For example, Shangri-La has the Shangri-La Academy. when I was with La Roche, when I was with Jinjiang Hotels and La Roche, collaborated and formed the La Roche Jinjiang International Hotel Management College. And for Hilton Worldwide, we have the Hilton Worldwide University. I think it's critical that every company who is serious about developing their talent needs to develop their own in-house academy or university or some form of development program and institution, because the needs of every business is different, and human resource must be able to respond to the business needs of the company to be relevant and to be an effective business partner with the business leaders. So I think it's critical to develop such ways of developing the talent. Also, such institutions, such academies, such universities also build up a lot of loyalty among the team members, the team leaders. They see it as an investment in their future. They see it as a way for them to develop and grow within the company. And you can see that they're very proud of every certificate, every diploma that they receive as a result of being developed internally by the company. Yeah, that's how I see it.
Do you have plans with Hilton to do similar kinds of academies?
We are always exploring possibilities of doing that. This is something we definitely are always on the lookout to do. Right now, we have a very effective learning management system. The Hilton Worldwide University offering more than 2,000 courses. But definitely, we are always on the watch out to look for possibility of running academy in China. And that's something that I continue to work on for the future.
Okay. Now, this this semester and the class that we're speaking to here is 30 students. Two of them are from mainland China, and the others from the U.S. and a variety of other places. If any of those students had an interest in working in the growing, incredibly fast-growing market in mainland China or in Asia, what would your advice and direction be for them?
I think from what we can see from the hotel owners that we work with, that we collaborate very closely with in China, there is more and more a demand for talent to be able to speak the Chinese language. I think this is very normal. When I was working in Europe, language plays a big part in where talent is being placed. For example, in France or Germany, if you are starting at a lower level, there is always a demand for talent to be able to interact with team members and with customers using the local language. So I would say that that the demand for Chinese-speaking talent is definitely growing in China. In the past, I would say that hotels, five-star hotels, international hotels, most of the time are being built and developed in what we call the first-tier cities like Shanghai and Beijing. But more and more five-star hotels, international hotels, are now opening in second and third-tier cities. As you move into the less developed areas of China, and you open hotels there, you will see that the demand of the owners and of the market and of the customer is that they are able to interact with our talent in their local language. So that's why the demand of Chinese-speaking talent is growing. I can tell you that for Hilton Worldwide, 100% of our XCOM are actually able to speak in the Chinese language. For our director of operations, the percentage is lower, and for the GM, it's lower. But we can see that this percentage is going up year by year. So you can see that the demand for Chinese-speaking talent is very critical. So I would say that for anyone who wants to come to China, develop your career, you should make it a point, objective to brush up your Chinese language, and use that to your advantage when you join the hotel industry in China. I think Chinese language, if you ask me, is much easier to learn than English, because the grammar in Chinese is not that difficult. It's very straightforward compared with English. And the pronunciation is the only key challenge. If you have the right environment and with the right effort, you should be able to pick up your Chinese language in progressively. I think it's possible. You know, when I first joined, when I first came to China to work, I remember that every morning I will be in the office by 7 a.m. and I will spend 2 hours every day learning and practicing my Chinese before I start work at 9 a.m. So I did that for 1 year. And after 1 year, I find that I was able to communicate and interact effectively with my colleagues. Yeah.
I that's fantastic. You, as you know, I've tried for 4 years, you know, but I didn't have the advantage of being in the environment where it was being spoken. I think that makes a big difference.
Yes. Yes, the environment is so important. So that's why, you know, I used to have a, when I was working in Zurich, my secretary was a German lady. And I remember she told me that because she wanted to brush up her English and learn her English, she actually went to London to work for a few years. And she told me she wasn't bothered about the salary or what level of job she was doing, but she just wanted to go to London and get immersed in the English speaking environment. And of course, after 2 years, English is definitely much better than many of the people that I know in Switzerland.
What are another question that the students might be particularly interested in this aspect of it. What are the salaries like for working there today versus perhaps what they would get in the U.S. or other places within Asia?
I think in China, if you can make it up the ranks and eventually become a general manager or executive committee member, the salary is definitely attractive. If you compare with U.S., with Europe, I would say that the salary and benefits in China are definitely pretty attractive for the hotel industry. Like a general manager in China, typically his salary will be net of taxes. In other words, the company takes care of his income tax. He will get benefits for his family. The studies of his children will be covered by the company. Medical benefits and insurance will be given. Usually they will have a very robust bonus plan as well as a long-term incentive. So I would say that generally they get pretty good salary and benefits once you make it up the ladder in the hotel industry, accommodation, living expenses, car, driver, many of these things will be taken care of in China. So I think it's definitely something that everyone should work hard for. And when you are successful, you will reap the benefits of your success. Yeah, that's all I think.
Absolutely. And a lot better packages than those of us in academics get.
I think it's definitely a very rewarding career in developing talent in China. I mean, I used to teach quite a lot in the academy, and I tell you there's no greater joy than you know to develop the talent for the future. And you know, David, you're doing a job that I dream of doing one day.
Well, you should be doing it. You're a great teacher. Well, you know, I really can't tell you how much I appreciate you getting up so early in the morning there to do this. It's nice to be able to communicate again. Although we're across long distances, we're still able to do it. And I think that's the beauty of what we have in technology and across borders today.
Yeah. It's my pleasure, David. Thanks for your kind invitation. And it's truly a pleasure for me to be able to speak with all your students. In fact, I invite if you are planning to do a field trip or a study trip to China, do let me know. I'm more than happy to help you to put that trip together and support you in terms of planning the program and the logistics for your visit. So that's something I really enjoy doing. I think China is a fantastic place, and I always invite people to come and learn more about it.
I couldn't agree with you more, and it's definitely in the plans. You and I started working on that one a long time ago, and it inspired me ever since then. I think it was a catalyst to why I ended up going back to Asia for the 5 years I spent out there. So I just can't appreciate it. I tell you how much I appreciate you taking the time to do this today, and we'll definitely be back in touch on that too. So I say,
appreciate it. Thank you very much.